Hi everyone, this is Deekshit. Welcome to my channel. In this particular video, I'm going to discuss about network policies in Kubernetes. So to work with this particular object in Kubernetes, the prerequisites are the Kubernetes server must be 1.8 or later than that particular version. To check the Kubernetes server version, you can use kubectl version. So you'll be able to get the version that you're using. And also the networking solutions that you have used while creating a Kubernetes cluster should be Calico or whichever the listed the networking solutions which is listed here. It should be in these kind of networking solutions. If you're using Flannel, what happens, the network policy will be created, but it won't be affected on your pod. So that's the reason any one of Calico or ViewNet or KubeRouter, so any one of the listed networking solutions you should use. And coming to network policies, so by default, pod is not isolated. That means it can accept the traffic from any source. So let's say you have created a pod and you have created a cluster IP for that. So that particular pod can be accessed by any of the pod inside the cluster. So wherein, like if you create a node pod, so then that particular pod, if it is that is a web application pod, so then it can be accessed from any place. So anywhere in the world. So that's the reason. So wherein you don't have much security in your pod. So when you create a network policy associated with any of the pod, so then your pod becomes isolated. So that means you can keep a restriction from where I can accept the traffic and from to where I can send the request. All these things you can define it in network policy and then attach it to the pods. So by this, you can make your pod little secured. So for example, let's say, as you can see on this diagram, see, I have three applications, three pods. So one pod is for my web application, which is running a web application. Another one is API server. So web application will interact with the API server. So API server in turn interacts with the database and get the data and give it back to the web application pod. So in this case, so the first thing is ingress. So my particular web application should accept only the request from 80 port, right? And if you want to restrict, like let's say from particular IP addresses range only I need to accept, so then that also you can define it by using network policy. And after accepting, so you need to send the request. So whatever the request that you have got, you need to process it and you need to send it back to the API server, right? So let's say my API server accepts the request in 5000 port. So you can specify egress rule in a web application pod so that it can send to particular pod, which is my API server pod. So that you can specify. In API pod, you can define again an ingress and egress. So ingress will be, it can accept the incoming request from this web application pod. And egress is basically, it can send the request to the database application. And in database pod, so wherein you can define again an ingress. So it is basically you can accept the request only from the API server. So this is in the beginning only, it will be a little confusing. So when we take smaller examples and when I discuss about ingress and egress, you'll have a better picture that time. And also network policies do not conflict. That means one pod can have multiple network policies. And it is like when you apply, like let's say one network policy as an ingress and another one as egress, so then it's a union of all the policies. So it will take the ingress from that network, first network policy, and the egresses from the next policy. So all the rules will be taken and then it will be applied onto the pod. And as you can see on the screen, so this is the picture that I've taken from Kubernetes official document. So the mandatory fields are API version, kind, metadata, and API version will be networking.k8.io/v1, and kind will be network policy, and the metadata, it depends on your project. You can give whatever the tags you need. And as you can see on the screen, so I'm creating, if I create this network policy, it will be on the default. And then this specification spec part. Here is the main thing, the pod selector. So here is what, like, you're telling, like, on which pod you're applying this network policy. So whichever the pod as label rule is equals to DB. So this particular network policy will be applied on that particular pod. And then we have policy types, ingress and egress. And so we can have in some of the cases, if you want only ingress, then you can have only ingress. In some cases, if you want only egress, you can have egress. That is possible. And after that, you're defining ingress rules and egress rules. So you're basically defining from where I need to accept the traffic and to where I can send the traffic. So these things you are defining it here. And in this blocks, ingress and egress, you can have different types of selectors. So basically we have four kinds of selectors that can be specified in an ingress from section or egress to section. So one is pod selector. So this is basically is used for particular pods in the same namespace. So when you apply this particular selector on particular this pod selector on particular pod, what happens is from the namespace, from the same namespace, the networking policy which should be allowed ingress sources. That means, like let's say you have one pod, so you have applied a network policy on that. So then from the same namespace, the pod will be like ingress and egress. You'll decide, like let's say there is one database pod and you have one web application pod. It should be in the same namespace, and you should apply the network policy on the database pod, wherein it will accept the request only from this web application. So that kind of a pod selector you can use. So from which pod I need to accept, or which for which pod I need to send the request. By using this selector, you can decide that. And namespace selector. So for example, sometimes what happens, assume like there is a application which is running in kube system namespace, but I want to access that. So that particular pod should be accessed by only the pods which are there in other namespace. The namespace name should be monitoring. The namespace name should be other, and the label of that particular namespace should be monitoring. So if that is the case, then only it should accept the request, or it should send the request. So in that case, you can go ahead and you can use namespace selector, and you can use the combination of pod selector and namespace selector. And here you can use both the combination. So sometimes either like namespace selector or pod selector. So when we discuss the examples, I'll going to show you that time. And another one is IP block. So you can define, so from which IP block I can accept the request and to which IP block I can send the request. And you can also specify, accept, let's say you have a bunch of IP addresses, and within that particular block of IP addresses you want to ignore. So that also you can specify. So by using this IP block selector. So now let's get onto the machine, and we will do a simple examples, and we will see how this selectors ingress and egress works. So whatever the files that I'm going to use for this particular demo, I've already uploaded onto Kubernetes repository, and which is under network policy folder. Also the steps that I'm going to follow, I've already documented it. You can go and you can follow the document, and you can execute the same steps in your Kubernetes cluster as well. So now let's start. So this is my Kubernetes cluster. So let me verify my Kubernetes version, kubectl version. So as you can see, I'm using 1.20. So that's fine enough. And then let me check how many nodes are there. Kubectl get nodes. So I have three nodes. I'm using GKE cluster, and also the networking solution is Calico in my case. Let me clear the screen. So now what we will do is, so first we will create a few of the container. So because that serves as my web server. So I'm taking this particular command line one, and then I'm executing this. So when I execute this, it will gonna create a service and also a pod. When I execute kubectl get all, so you'll be able to see a pod with hello web, and then the service with hello web. And if you see the label of that particular pod, let me show you that, kubectl get po. show labels. So when you execute this command, so you'll be able to see the labels as well. So my particular prod as app is equals to hello. And now, so we will create a network policy. We will be applying that network policy on this particular pod. So let's have a look into that particular network policy that we will gonna create. So this is a network policy definition. The kind should be network policy, API version, which is networking.k8.io/v1. And in the metadata, I've just given a name tag and I've just given hello, from foo. So it's a random name that I've given. And then specifications here, the policy types, I'm just defining an ingress rule on this particular network policy. And here, the next one is pod selector. So if you remember, we have already created a pod, which is app is equals to hello as our match label. So whichever the pod has this labels, so that those pods will be attached to this particular network policy. And now, so I'm defining ingress rules. So from is a keyword. Under ingress, you need to define from where we are accepting the request. So here I'm again specifying the pod selector. So I'm using a selector I've shown you, right? Four selectors are there. In that, I'm using a pod selector. So basically, I can accept the request from the pods which has label as app is equals to foo. So now, so let's go ahead and create this network policy. Kubectl apply -f. I've already cloned this one. That's why I'm just, okay, so the network policy is created. Now let's go and create a pod with a label foo. Okay, and let's copy this command. And I'm just creating a pod with an interactive mode. And you can see when I come out of interactive mode, so this particular one, the pod will be deleted because I have used -rm. Now, so let's try to ping that one. And I'm using a wget hello world. This is the service name. You'll be able to see here, right? Hello web. And the port I've defined is 8080. So, and the cluster service type is cluster IP, right? So that's the reason I'm just doing wget and I'm using wget's options. I'm giving timeout is equals to 2 and the URL. So when I execute this particular command, I should be able to see this output. So this is correct because my pod label is app is equals to foo. So then I should be able to send the request to my particular pod. Now let's take one more scenario. So wherein now we will gonna create a pod with label app is equals to other. Now when I try to access, when I try to wget my web, hello web, so now I should get an error. So let's check that. Now I'm doing wget -qo. And now when I execute it, so it should fail with a error saying wget download timeout because it'll wait for 2 seconds. If it is not able to do anything, so then it'll fails with this particular error. So now our network policy is successful. We have created ingress rule on our hello web, wherein it'll accept requests only from the pods, whichever as a label app is equals to foo. So now let me exit. Let me delete that network policy. Kubectl. Delete -f and the file with which I've created. Now it is deleted. So that let that web server be there because I need it for other example. So now I'm gonna create one more web application. So which does the same, but here the only changes I'm changing app is equals to allow to. Only the label is changed. That's it. So let me copy paste and these things are also created. and I do kubectl get all and show labels. So I have two web applications now. So with one is allo or dash web and allo dash web dash two, and you can see the labels here. So allo two and here also allo two. Now what I'll do is, now I'm going to create egress network policy. So let me open that network policy. This is a network policy, and you can see kind is equals to network policy, API version is networking.k8.io/v1, and the metadata depends on, again, your project. You can give whatever the tags that you need. And when it comes to specifications, now I'm taking egress rule. So policy type egress. So now I'm defining the outbound rules. So here, again, I'm giving pod selector. So whichever the pod has labels, app is equals to foo, that pods will be affected by this network policy. And I'm defining an egress rule. So I'm telling to, from this foo pod to where I can, from foo pod where I can send the request, that is what the egress means. So from this particular pod, to allo pod, I can send the request. Any other pod which has other than like app is equals to allo to or like any other labels, then I won't be able to send the request for that. So now let's go ahead and create this network policy. I also have specified ports. So the TCP and the UDP ports. So from this ports only the communication will happen. So now let's go ahead and create that particular pod. So but before that, let's create this network policy, kubectl apply -f, and so this is a network policy. And now let's do kubectl get network policy. Let's see whether it has been created or not. Yes, it has been created, and the age of that is 8. And the pod selector, as you can see, app is equals to foo. Now we will gonna create a pod which has a app label as foo, and this is the command for that. And all these commands I have already given in that GitHub page, wherein I've told you, right? Like I've given step by step all these commands present there, and you can copy paste while working on this one. And now my app label is foo. So now when I try to ping my web application, which has my pod label is allo web, so I should be able to get some output. So as you can see, I'm able to get output. So when I ping my second web application, so which is the pod label is allo two, so it shouldn't work. I should get an error saying that wget download timeout. So this is how, if you want to define any egress rule on a particular pod, this is how you're going to define it. So now what we will do is we will try to use combination of pod selector and namespace selector, and we will put that network policy on particular pod, and then let's see how it works. So the next one is I can delete this particular network policy which I've created, kubectl delete -f the network policy file which I've created. Let me clear the screen. And now what we will do is we will gonna create a policy which is of two selectors. So till now I've used a pod selector as my selector in both of the examples, right? Now what I'll do is I'll gonna use two selectors. Sorry, there is some mistake with this one, but let me do a cat on this. So as you can see, this is the actual file. Let me copy this one. So this is actual file. I don't know, somehow I've jumbled it down. So the kind is network policy, and the version is networking.k8.io/v1. And the metadata, depending on your project, you can give it. And the namespace, it's up to you. If you want to deploy this network policy, then you can give a particular namespace. Here, if you see, I'm again using a pod selector. So whichever the pod as labels app is equals to web, those pods will be affected by this network policy. And then I'm defining ingress. So if you don't give anything, so it is not mandatory to give this policy types. So you can directly define this ingress rules. And so as you can see, I've defined from keyword and I've used two kinds of selector. One is namespace selector. And here I'm defining match labels, team colon operations. So whichever the namespace as label team is equals to operations, then only from that I will accept the request. And also, and it should be the pod selector. Here there are two conditions. Both the conditions should satisfy. So if a web, the pod match label like app is equals to web, if it wants to accept the request, so then the pod should be there in a particular namespace, which is the namespace label should be operation, and also the pod label should be type is equals to monitoring. So now let's go ahead and create this particular network policy. So before that, let me create a pod with a label app is equals to web. So this is a command for that. So let me copy paste. And so now when I do kubectl get all, I should be able to see web pod and also web service. So if I do show labels, I'll be able to see the labels as well. Okay, as you can see, app is equals to web. So now when I create that network policy, so then it'll be applied on this particular pod. So let's go ahead and create that kubectl apply hyphen f and web hello all. So let me clear the screen. And now, so what I'll do is, now I'll gonna create a namespace, because my requirement is I should have a namespace with a label, with the label team is operations. Like if you see the network policy, so this is what team, the namespace label should be team is equals to operations. So now let's go ahead and create the namespace with the name other, and we will create the label for that as well. So let's create this and create a label for that. And once that is done, we can see the label. So now do kubectl get namespace show label. Show labels. So when you do this, you can see there is a namespace which is named other, and the label for that is team is equals to operations. And now, so let's go ahead and create that network policy. So now I have a pod and also the namespace as team is equals to operations. And now, so let's go ahead and create that network policy. Kubectl apply hyphen f and okay. So this one I've already created, I guess. Yeah, I've already created this one. And now, so let's create a pod with both the condition fail. So here, if you see this pod label is not app is equals. So this, we will go to this web allow all. So here, if you see that particular command, my label is not monitoring, and also the namespace label is not team is equals to operations. In this particular command, if you see, the pod label is also not correct and the namespace label is also not correct. So when I execute now, and then when I try to access my web application from this pod, I should get error basically. So it will fail. And now let me exit from that. And again, I'm creating one more pod. Here, if you see, one condition is satisfied because I am giving type is equals to monitoring. The pod selector will be satisfied now. If you see my network policy, the pod selector will be satisfied, but this is an AND operation. The namespace selector also should be satisfied, then only this web pod, the output of web pod will be seen. So now let's go ahead and test that. Sorry about that. Let me clear the screen. I'll take this command and when I execute this, so when I try to access my web application, so I should be able to get the error itself because I am satisfying only one condition, which is pod label, but the namespace still, namespace label is still not satisfied. So now again, I'll do exit. And here again, this particular pod, here I'm creating it in a proper namespace. So sorry, this particular command. So here, if you see, I'm creating a pod in namespace, which is other. So other namespace has a label, name like this label it has, right? So team is equals to operation. So now when I create, now the namespace condition will be satisfied, but even then it should fail because the pod selector condition is not satisfied. So now let me execute, do the wget web default. So when I execute, even then it should fail. Now when I do exit again and create a pod by using this command. So here, if you see, two conditions are satisfied. So the one is the pod label is type is equals to monitoring, and I'm creating this particular pod in the namespace other. So the namespace other as label team is equals to operation. So both the operator conditions are satisfied. Now when I run wget in this particular pod, so I should be able to get some output. So now you can see this is nginx welcome page. So I'm getting some output. So this is how, as you can see, you can use the combination of both the things. And the next one is, now we have seen the AND operation, right? So both the operator condition should satisfy. So sometimes you might have a situation wherein like either one of it, if it that satisfies, then you can accept the request. In that case, you need to do a little change in your network policy. So that is, so here you can define as a list those selectors as list. So then if you define it as list, so then it'll be considered as R. So either the name selector should be satisfied, or pod selector should be satisfied. When I save this one, oh sorry, I'm not a sudo user. So let me do sudo vi . So now I'll be able to insert. And when I just give space, so when I do this one, now when I apply it again, kubectl apply -f, and now that is configured. So now when I take these three conditions, first condition, it will be failed because both the conditions are failing. So let's take and let's check it for the confirmation. So now when I execute wget here, so it should fail. If my network policy is correct. Yeah, it is working as expected. Now, let me create one more pod. So now it is a R, right? Either one of the conditions should satisfy. Now I should be able to get that nginx welcome page. So yeah. So these two things also should be successful. So I'm just testing with this one. Anyway, the last one will work fine because both the conditions will be satisfied. So it'll work fine. So this is a fuant and or, so that operations also are there, like, so depending on your requirement. So this is what we did, right? We have just defined it as like array. Okay, and the next one is I'm not creating this particular network policy, so I'm gonna just explain this one. So rather than this, so maybe I'll take a YML file, which will be better. Maybe I'll just replace this content with this. Here, if you see again, API version is networking.kh.io/v1, and the kind is networking policy and metadata. So depending on your project, you can give tags, whatever you need. And the pod selector, the pod with role is equals to DB as match labels will be affected by this network policy. And policy types here, if you can see, I have both ingress and egress. So you're defining from where I need to accept the request and to where I can send the request. In ingress, so I have all the three selectors that I've used here. So you can see IP block and the namespace selector and the pod selector. Here it is, you can see I've defined these selectors as an array, YML array, right? So if any one of these conditions satisfies, then this pod, which has a label role is equals to DB, can accept the request. So if I take off this array type, if it is not array, so then all three conditions should be satisfied. So here I've used a IP block and I've defined a CIDR block. So from this CIDR block, if you're trying to access, it should be able to access. I have one more tag here, which is accept. So except these IP address block, all others will be able to accessible, because I have told you, right, like this is possible in the range of address, a particular part of range, if you don't want to allow, so then you can use this particular accept tag and you can define it. And then I have a namespace selector. So this I have already shown. So whichever the namespace as label project is equals to my project, from there also you will be able to send the request to a pod which has a label role is equals to DB. And the pod selector, again, it is the same. And ports I've defined, the port should be TCP, protocol should be TCP, and the port should be 6379. And so egress, in this YML, I've used ingress and egress, both the things. And here also, this DB, like pod which has a label role is equals to DB, can send the request to pods which is there in two IP addresses, which is ranging from 10.0.0.0/24, whichever the IP addresses are there in this range, I can send the request. And also the port should be 5978 and the protocol should be TCP. So this is how, like, we can use combination of selectors, and in the selectors also we can kind of create and operation, both should be successful, and we can expect our operation, like any one of the selector condition can success, be satisfied. And we can use a couple of selectors in the same network policy, and we can use both ingress and egress. And I've already mentioned, so one pod can have multiple network policies, and it'll be used, it'll be summed up, and it'll be taken all the network policies. So this is what the network policy is about. So I've taken very simple examples to explain the network policies. So when you go with the actual requirement, like the databases and like web application and API server, in the beginning slide I've shown you diagram, right? If you go with that scenarios, so you're making your pod a very secured. And if you're especially working with sensitive applications, which has very sensitive information, so this plays a very important role. You can specify from where I can accept the request and where you can send the request. So this makes your pod isolated, and you're defining the rules. So that's it for this video. Have a good day. If you like the video, please like and share. Thank you.